Hey, Woody, it's a new Mr. Cartwright video.
Yeah, I wonder if anybody actually watches the math part.
That is a sad, strange little man who has my pity.
I hope Mr. Cartwright does our math videos next.
His costumes are so dumb, though.
As long as he doesn't sing anymore.
It's like he doesn't even have a mirror.
What if we were in the intro right now?
Oh no, I am not ready.
Code red. Bail, bail, bail.
All toys assemble. We have been in the intro this whole time. We must get ready.
Hey, how's it going, my math friends? Congratulations, we made it through another week of quarantine. Guys, we're getting really good at this stuff. I mean, if there was a quarantine Special Olympics, we would not sign up for that. This is horrible. Let's be done with this. I'm looking forward to seeing all you guys back on Monday. Remember, Monday we have a review day of everything that we've covered, versus one and two variable statistics. And on Tuesday we have our exam. So we're going to have to hit the ground running when we get back. I know you probably can't see it, but our quote for today is one of my favorites. And normally I just say the shorter part, but I think today it's useful to say the whole thing. So if there is ever a tomorrow, when we are not together, there is something you must always remember. You are braver than you believe, stronger than you seem, and smarter than you think. But the most important thing is, even if we're apart, I'll always be with you in my heart. So, that is from one of my favorite books of all time, Winnie the Pooh. It is also a wonderful movie and all sorts of other things as well, and I suggest you check it out. It's not just for, well, it is for kids, but it makes me feel good. Anyways, today we'll be talking a little bit about correlations. Correlations are when the data set follow a trend, right? And if they follow a trend, you can put on a line of best fit, right? And that's how we would describe one and two variables, two variable statistics, right? You have your X variable and you have your Y variable. And together, do they form a trend, right? As X goes up, does Y go up as well? Or as X goes up, does Y go down, right? And so the first two we're gonna talk about is positive and negative. So a positive correlation would be as X increases, Y increases, right? And so they form a bracket in the positive direction. Now, there's degrees of strength of correlation, but we'll get to those next. Right now, I want to talk about negative correlations, which would just be the same thing, but with a downward trend. All right, so you can have positive and negative correlations, you can have flat correlations, you can have no correlations, right? No correlation would be the dots are all spread out all over the place. Moving on, next up, we have strong versus weak. A strong correlation can be really strong, where all the lines are very close. It can be perfect, which means they are exactly on a line. And the strong versus weak determines how far the majority of the points are away from the line. So the more spread out you are, the weaker your correlation is overall, whether it's positive, negative, or flat. So a weak correlation still has a general trend, but the dots are a little bit more spread apart, right? So it's generally a positive trend. It's generally going up, but there's a couple of them that both don't really work and are very, very spread out from the line of regression. You can measure how strong or weak your data is based on your R value. Your R value is what the computer will spit out after you've done a line of regression. If you have a weak correlation, your R value will be real low, right? I don't know if that's possible. But if you have a very strong correlation, your R value would be very, very high. So if it's like perfect, it would be like 0.9. If it's like semi-perfect, it might be 0.8 or something, right? So depending on how strong or weak your correlation is, gives you a better idea of how well you can predict that data going forward, how good your extrapolation is. If you have a perfect linear regression, your extrapolation is also perfect. Your interpolation is perfect. The closer your R value, the closer your regression, your distance from the line is to perfect, the better your predictions will be, right? And you want to be wary of predictions that use low R values, right? Because if you have this low correlation, this weak correlation, they say it's positive, and they're like, okay, so here, right? I'm going to use a different color real fast. Here, right? This is like, if it was your money, right? That's where you should be if you've worked this long. But then you look at this dude over here, right? And like, he doesn't follow the trend at all. And that would be a very, very bad prediction for me, for that dude or that gal. I don't know. Dots don't really have genders, do they? But either for this point right here, he's looking at the statistic being like, what happened, right? And that kind of brings me to my point that statistics don't really mean anything. You are not a statistic. You are an individual. And I want to, and you're actually a very qualified and talented individual, in my humble opinion, for a couple of reasons, right? One, we live in America. America is like way over here in percentile for like how much money we have and stuff like that. Access to healthcare, clean drinking water, food, wonderful educational system, rights for children and stuff like that. You know, you guys don't have to go to labor or anything. So that is a advantage you have. Let's say it's like top two standards, right? You also have a wonderful education system here, which we are actually in person. For the most part, and we are one of very few schools in the country that's doing that right now. So you are probably in the top one standard or top two standards of education. Actually, yeah, definitely two, because like Texas and Florida are open. So we would definitely be in the top two standards of people in this education crisis in America. And then finally, your NWEA scores. Everybody in this class scored at least above the 70th percentile, which would be like right here. So our NWA scores place us right there. So we have at least three or four different advantages. This places us in the top end of the distribution scale. We should use those to the best of our ability to save the world, right? Or just to help your world, right? Save your world. It brings me to this movie that I like a lot called Unbreakable. And in Unbreakable, this guy was a superhero because he was in this part of the bell curve, right? He was so far too off of center that his bones were so much stronger than normal people's bones that they couldn't be broken, right? And that, and he became a superhero because of that. It's kind of stupid, but at the same time, there is a range of any set of data, and most of them form a normal distribution curve. But you do not, right? You are like the guy in Unbreakable. You're practically a superhero. You got a bunch of advantages, and whether you use them for whatever reason is up to you, but I just want you guys to know that you're awesome. You're not a statistic, and statistics don't really mean a whole lot to the individual. That brings us to the end of today's lesson video. Please return to the live classroom if you have any questions. Let me know there. Have a wonderful day.